Hi dear students, so in the last two sessions we discussed about maximum Gilbert sequencing, Sanders automated and semi-automated sequencing, and now we are going to discuss about pyro sequencing. In 1993, Virgil Peterson, Matthias Herland and Pal Nyren described the pyro sequencing method. This method is based on the detection of the pyrophosphate released during the chain reaction of nucleotide addition. Here, the order of the nucleotide is determined by the pyrophosphate released during the joining of two adjacent nucleotides, that is 3-OH and 5-P. In contrast with the other method, instead of a single polymerase, two additional enzymes are required in the pyrosequencing method. So, the main three enzymes involved are DNA polymerase without any exonuclease activity, luciferase and sulfuryase. All three enzymes work in a sequential manner for the detection of pyrophosphate. Here the reaction is completed in three steps. The enzyme polymerase add the DNTPs to the single stranded DNA. If the correct complementary base is added, the pyrophosphate is released. The enzyme sulfuryase converts the pyrophosphate into the ATP energy with the help of APS, that is adenosine 5-phosphosulfate. The ATP acts as a substrate for the luciferase activity. With the help of the ATP substrate, the luciferase converts the luciferin into oxyluciferin in the presence of oxygen and the photon of light is released. Once a correct nucleotide is added, the amount of the light released by the enzymatic reaction is detected by the charge device, coupled camera, photodiode or photomultiplier tube. Based on the substrate used in the technique, two types of pyrosequencing methods are available. It's termed as solid phase pyrosequencing and liquid phase pyrosequencing. Let's check the whole process. Pyrosequencing is a sequence technique in which incorporation of DNTPs in the DNA is detected in the form of light. When DNTP is added on the template DNA, pyrophosphate is released and the pyrophosphate can be converted to ATP by enzyme ATP sulfurase. The ATP can be utilized by enzyme luciferase to generate light. This is the same enzyme that generates lights in fireflies. Along with ATP as energy source, luciferase also uses oxygen and luciferin as a substrate. And one of the interesting questions is that addition of any DNTPs, that is ATG or C, will generate pyrophosphate. So how do we know which nucleotide is added? So for that, in order to solve this problem, the reaction is carried out in a flow cell where only one DNTP is added at a time. The flow cell is controlled by a computer which knows which DNTP is added. Because the reagents are coming in and out of the cell, the template DNA can be easily flushed out of the cell. To avoid this, template DNA is immobilized on a bead which remains in the flow cell. Also, there are many copies of the same template DNA which is generated by PCR. Because of this, when DNTP is added, large number of pyrophosphate is released. Hence, the light produced is intense and easily detected by the sensor. If DNTP is not incorporated, no light is detected. Hence, the sequence information of the DNA can be easily obtained with light. It should be noted that there can be unused DNTP in the flow cell. It can be removed by a pyrase enzyme. The advanced version of pyrosequencing allows sequencing of the different template in the simple one. For this purpose, beads having different template DNA are kept in a pico-tighter plate. All the template DNA are PCR amplified and immobilized on a single bead. Each well of pico-tighter plate will have single bead with many copies of DNA. The picotheater plate is then kept in a closed cell where the reagents are added and flushed. Can see the identification of nucleotides here with the emission of light. The pyrosequencing method is more accurate than the Sanger sequencing, which has a capacity to add up to 500 nucleotides. The major advantage of pyrosequencing is the speed of the reaction. Another modification of the Sanger's change elimination method is the whole genome shotgun sequencing. Instead of a single gene or few base pairs, this method is powerful enough to sequence the entire genome of an organism. The principle of the shotgun is the same as Sanger's method. One additional step of DNA fragmentation allows to read multiple fragments. The entire genome of an organism is fragmented with the help of endonuclease enzymes or by mechanical techniques. We get the smaller fragments of DNA which can be sequenced individually into the machine. After that, the computer-based software analyzes each and every overlapping fragment and reassemble it to generate the complete sequence of the entire genome. It can be divided into four main steps. The first one is the fragmentation of the DNA with the help of restriction endonucleases or by physical method. And then is the formation of libraries of the subfragments. The fragments are ligated in vectors and an entire library for various vectors are generated. And the third step is the sequencing of these fragments. And each library is sequenced individually. The overlapping fragments are called the contigs and these are read by the computer. And in this you can see the whole process. First thing is the fragmentation of DNA with the help of restriction endonucleases or by any mechanical technique. Later, formation of libraries of the subfragments when the fragments are located in vectors. Later, sequencing of each library. And then sequencing of each library and then generation reading the contents by the computer. Next method is clone-by-clone sequencing. For sequencing the whole genome, the clone-by-clone method is also used instead of whole genome shotgun sequencing. Instead of smaller fragments, large clumps of DNA fragments are constructed through mapping and the location of each fragment is noted. And in the next step, using the bacterial artificial chromosome, multiple copies of each fragment are generated for accurate sequencing. Every copied fragment are fragmented into smaller pieces and inserted into the vectors. And here the sequencing procedure is almost similar to the shotgun. And the overlapping fragments are assembled by the computer. The context that is generated will be assembled by the computer. And the sequences are arranged on each chromosome based on their location. The next one is the next generation sequencing and it is widely used in this time. The next generation sequencing platform is different from the Sanger technique or chain termination method of DNA sequencing. It broadly amplifies millions of copies of a particular fragment in a massively parallel fashion and the results are analyzed with a computational program. The NGS process mainly consists of four steps, that is library preparation, cluster generation, DNA sequencing and DNA analysis. So, let's see what's in library preparation. The library preparation is a combination of two reactions, that is fragmentation and ligation. The fragmentation of complementary DNA or DNA fragment is done by restriction digestion. After that, the smaller DNA fragments that are generated are ligated with the known DNA sequence. The known DNA sequences are called the adapters and the process is called adapter ligation. Once the adapters are ligated, the library of the smaller DNA fragments is generated. And then the uncoated DNA fragments are washed by the washing buffer, and the process of and this process of lightly preparation is also called as tagmentation. Next is the cluster generation. Here we can see the role of adapters. The short oligonucleotide sequences are immobilized on the solid surface, which is a complementary to our the adapter we were previously talking about, complementary to the adapter sequences. And once the library of a fragmented DNA is loaded into the cell, it is bound with the immobilized oligos on the solid surface. And by bridge amplification, the cluster of DNA sequence is generated. Here in bridge amplification, the DNA fragments bend over and bind to the next oligo, which creates a bridge. And hence the term, hence it is termed as bridge amplification. And a primer binds to this DNA sequence and it is amplified vertically. And in this way, two new single stranded DNA is generated by bridge amplification method. Here you can see the library preparation and later the cluster generation, that is bridge amplification, and the DNA bending over the next complementary oligo. And after the amplification process is completed, two new single-stranded DNA are generated. One was the forward DNA and one will be the reverse DNA. And finally, the third step is sequencing. As the polymerase adds a nucleotide into the bridge amplification, the amplification signals are recorded each time, and this will generate multiple sequencing databases for the DNA sequences. And the data generates are aligned to the reference genome sequence, and by doing this, we can identify whether there is any addition, deletion, or variation in the sequence. You can see the whole process of NGS here, like the ligation and fragmentation and ligation process, bridge amplification and binding to the oligos, then addition of the DNPs to the newly amplified DNA, then the sequencing and the data generation and data analysis can be found here. NGS is the most advanced, fast and accurate, and it is a 100% FDA technique in modern day science. Besides all the sequencing method, there are also other sequencing platforms used in the genomic lab, like single molecular real-time sequencing, RNAP, SMRT, HeliCoAP, DNA nanopore sequencing, solid sequencing, Illumina sequencing, colony sequencing, high throughput sequencing. Let us just see the applications of DNA sequencing. In forensic science, it is used for parental verification, criminal investigation, identification of individual through any of the available samples such as hair, nail, blood or tissue. And in medical science, DNA sequencing can be used in the identification of genes responsible for hereditary disorders. And in the agriculture sector, GMO species can be identified using this method. It's used in exon or intron repeat sequence and tandem repeat identification and detection. Also for the microbial identification and characterization, and also has a great application in the oncology and cancer studies to identify the cancer causing genes. And in the latest scientific trends, the development of gene therapies and the concept of personalized medicines cannot be fulfilled without the NGS-like robust technique.